When life's road looks beyond repair, Milton can sort it out.
Milton.
He's got a bag for your mild air. He'll make the whole world shout.
He stopped my nuisance calls. He saved our library. He cured my dad's snoring. He went back in time and gave the Sopranos a proper ending.
Hello, my name's Milton Jones and I like to help. There are many things wrong with the world today. Like when people who are addressing the United Nations start by saying, "So where are you all from?" And then there's never time for anything else. Like when Starbucks say they do fair trade coffee, but in reality, when you try and swap two football stickers for a cappuccino, they just aren't interested. And when people say that criminals always return to the scene of a crime, why are they still surprised that there are so many Australians over here? My quest is to solve these problems and help as many people as possible in the next half hour. I live with my trusty friend Anton and our landlady, Pauline, who looks after us. So, anyone needing help today, Anton?
Well, it's strange. Only newsagents seem to be replying to our adverts in newsagents' windows.
Ah, maybe I put them up the wrong way round.
Oh, dear. Right, well, we better get going. The wedding invitation said be at the church by 2 o'clock.
Excellent. Now, shall we take rice to throw at the happy couple?
Well, I think we'll have to. If you remember, you served us all tandoori chicken with confetti last night.
Ah.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to witness the joining in matrimony of this man and this woman.
Milton, you're crying. The bride does look beautiful, doesn't she?
No, you don't understand. She's wearing the same dress as me.
Well, don't let her see you wearing it or she'll be furious.
You're right. She'll be thinking we could have got 2 for 1 at Millet's.
That explains the guy ropes. Well... Just sit quietly. Stop fidgeting.
And if anyone knows any lawful reason as to why these two people should not be joined together in holy matrimony, they must declare it now.
Ah!
Yes?
Sorry, I just sat on my car keys.
Milton, sit back down.
Sorry.
Well, in that case, we shall proceed. Is...
Ow!
What now?
Sat on a tent peg.
Perhaps I'd better look after everything. Hang on, these aren't your car keys.
No, they're for the wedding car. I've completely filled it with balloons.
Did you remember to inflate them this time?
Ah. That'll probably be the rear axle braking.
Milton, I think perhaps we better sneak out before you cause any more damage.
Oh, but I've got to stay for the bit where we throw rice at the happy couple.
Well, normally I'd say yes, but I've just seen that catering-sized pan of hot risotto.
Never waste leftovers. As part of my plan to help people, I offer therapy for those who need it most. And that wedding car business reminds me of someone I helped recently. Someone who thought he was a balloon.
Well, this is all very embarrassing.
And not at all. I think we can make you feel better about the whole balloon thing.
Good.
May I suggest acupuncture?
No! What?
There is one problem with acupuncture. Sticking needles into you might cure you, but it could be fatal for your voodoo doll.
Maybe I'll leave it.
Relax, relax. Sometimes it's good to face our fears.
Right, I see. How much is it?
Well, if you're worried about cost, it's £50 a pop. Tell you what, let's try something radical. Massage. Just lie back on the couch.
Right, okay. Oh, yeah.
Now, instead of just a balloon, yeah. Imagine...
Oh, ow!
You're a little dog.
Ow!
Now...
Oh.
A giraffe!
Get off me!
All right, I'll let you go.
Ah, Milton. It's good to be home again.
Knock, knock. Hello, boys.
Pauline, always a pleasure to see our favourite landlady.
Oh, look at you, Anton, togged up in your finery.
Yeah, this old thing.
Milton, do you want a hand putting up that marquee?
This is a wedding dress.
Oh, you two went to a wedding then. Oh, hang on. You two didn't, one of those civil... Anton, I thought you were... Oh, well, that explains it.
No. No, goodness. Imagine.
In his dreams.
No, wait, explains what exactly?
So, good wedding?
Had its moments. They wrote their own vows.
Didn't think much of hers, especially that bit that went, get that weird bloke in a dress out of here.
Understandable, though.
The other speech was rather confrontational, I thought.
Yes, that was you being cautioned by the police, Milton.
You mean PC risotto face?
So, how did you end up at this wedding?
Ah, well, the groom and I were at college together.
And I was Anton's plus one.
Which meant, apparently, that Milton had to go around saying exactly what I said, but an hour later.
Oh, that reminds me. Milton, you'll never hit the vicar with risotto from here. Oh, I stand corrected.
I don't sound like that.
You will in an hour.
Oh, I do love a good wedding, me. I'm sorry you didn't enjoy it.
Well, it started badly. They made us all sit in this enormous stone fridge for an hour.
That was the church.
Well, organising a wedding's not easy, you know. Lavinia's having a terrible time of it.
Oh, I'm not sure I know Lavinia.
Oh, you know Lavinia. Morris and Eleanor's girl. Used to run the tennis club?
No.
Moved back from Kensington a few years ago.
Can't really picture her.
Looks like Robert De Niro.
I always shout something random in the street at her, like, do you like anchovies? Just to try and get her to look round and say, are you talking to me?
De Niro, yeah, it's very good.
Well, she could really use some help.
Well, I can do that. I could set up a wedding business. She could be our first customer.
Oh, I'll give her a call straight away.
It was great to be helping people with their weddings. Helping is in the blood. 100 years ago, my great-grandfather helped his school invent a new game.
Right, scrum, boys.
I say, Wilkins, this new game is rubbish.
I know, Jones. Strange to think that it was only invented a few weeks ago. Some chap at rugby was playing footer and picked up the bally ball and ran with it.
I know. It makes you wonder what we could come up with here at Volleyball Hall.
Yes, and we've come so close to inventing games so many times.
I know. Do you remember last year in the dining room when Professor Plum hit Colonel Mustard with the lead piping and only broke his collarbone?
Yes, shame.
Look, someone's injured. I've got an idea. Perhaps if we go over and try to extract his funny bone, I'll get my little tweezers.
Steady now. Oh!
What do you think you're doing, Jones?
Trying to invent a new game, sir.
Jones, you've been warned time and time again. You're expelled.
Don't care. I was going anyway. Already packed. Come on, Elsie. I'll just load up this last trunk. My lucky shovel.
By Jove, he's got it. Well done, Jones. And from now on, the school shall be known as St. Buckaroo's.
You're sure that's how it happened, Milton?
Absolutely. It says so on Wikipedia. Well, it does now. So soon my wedding business was up and running, and the house was ready to receive customers.
Yeah, very good, Milton. Atmospheric.
Do you like the low lighting?
Low lighting? It's actually quite bright. Ow! Hanging low. I see. Still, I like the string quartet.
Well, one of my great uncles was in the band on the Titanic.
Hello, band members. The iceberg's done for this ship, and there's not enough lifeboats. So I say we play on. Violins, are you with me? Sounds like the water's done for them too. How about the trumpets? How about you, Celine? Well, that's something, I suppose. So it's just me then. But at least I can use my trusty cello to lift these poor people's spirits.
Good. So that's the music sorted. Ooh. Here's another customer. Oh, it's Robert De Niro. Ah, you must be Lavinia.
Yes, that's right.
Do you like anchovies?
I beg your pardon?
She didn't say it.
welcome. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.